Luvoir, HST shocking successor. The next generation of brand new telescopes will provide us with very important insights into the universe. In the upcoming years, for example, we might discover we're not alone, but other forms of life exist on some exoplanets. Such powerful telescopes will be equipped with instruments developed with the most advanced technologies of our time. Not only will we have a deeper understanding of the far universe, but also our view of the solar system will change completely. These telescopes are the maximum expression of our insane curiosity. Some months ago, the sky was gifted with the James Webb Space Telescope, now orbiting in a halo trajectory around the L2 Lagrangian point. But the next telescope to be launched will probably be the Luvoir telescope. It will be the shocking successor of the Hubble Space Telescope. But what kind of technologies will be implemented? And what are the real goals of this mission? Let's find out in this new video. So far, the Luvoir Large UV Optical Infrared Telescope is only a telescope concept, but a really nice one, I must say. It will be a large, multi-wavelength, serviceable observatory, following the heritage of the Hubble Space Telescope. Its unique science goals, if accomplished, would enable huge advances across a broad range of astrophysics. The proposed launch date was set in mid-2030, and if everything goes well, it will reach an orbit around the L2 Lagrangian point. So we will have two of the most powerful telescopes, JWST and Luvoir, orbiting somewhere around that point. The architecture of this telescope is still uncertain. Engineers are considering two models, one with a 15-meter mirror, Architecture A, and another with an 8-meter mirror, Architecture B. If A is chosen, the telescope will probably be launched on NASA's planned Space Launch System, SLS, the same rocket that's now having troubles with the Artemis 1 mission, while Architecture B is being designed to launch on a heavy-lift vehicle with a 5-meter diameter fairing. The primary mirror for Luvoir A is an on-axis 3-mirror anastigmat system, TMA. This configuration would enable high optical quality across a wide field of view. Luvoir B is an off-axis TMA. If this architecture is chosen, it will be one of the best telescopes for the observations of exoplanets. Both designs include a fine steering mirror to achieve ultra-fine pointing stability for all the instruments. But what are Luvoir's goals? First of all, our brand new telescope will address the age-old question, are we alone in the universe? To answer the question, Luvoir will be equipped with two channels, a UV visible UVIS channel covering 200 nanometers, 950 nanometers, and a near IR near channel covering the range 800 nanometers to 2500 nanometers. But this is not the end of the story. Luvoir is not a simple telescope. It will be equipped with state-of-the-art instruments. Let's take a look at them. To start with, we can talk about the LUMOS instrument. LUMOS, Luvoir Ultraviolet Multi-Object Spectrograph, is a special spectrograph. A spectrograph basically collects the light and splits it into the entire range of wavelengths, thus making a spectrum. This spectrum is crossed by lines, which tell astronomers what kind of elements they are observing in a faraway galaxy or star. Taking a spectrum is a really expensive task, and usually one studies one object at a time. But LUMOS is not a simple spectrograph. It is a multi-object spectrograph covering far ultraviolet, 100 nanometers, through visible, 1,000 nanometer wavelengths, capable of observing hundreds of targets at once in a wide field of view. It can be considered a successor to the Hubble Space Telescope Imaging Spectrograph, STIS, instrument, with two orders of magnitude higher efficiencies, multi-object capability, and a wide-field multi-band imaging channel. Can you imagine how good it will be? Another fantastic instrument we will have on board the Luvoir telescope is Eclips. It stands for Extreme Coronagraph for Living Planetary Systems, and it's a quite complex instrument. A coronagraph is a disc to be put on the telescope, and it is designed to suppress the overwhelming glare of starlight so that faint planets can be seen adjacent to their parent stars. Coronagraph instruments are extreme examples of light rejection and precise photometry because the total brightness from the solar corona is less than 1/1,000,000th the brightness of the Sun. The apparent surface brightness is even fainter because, in addition to delivering less total light, the corona has a much greater apparent size than the Sun itself. For instance, during a total solar eclipse, the Moon acts as an occluding disk, and any camera in the eclipse path may be operated as a coronagraph until the eclipse is over. As you can understand, a coronagraph turns out to be really useful when it comes to the study of exoplanets. In this way, Eclips would enable, for the first time, direct imaging and spectroscopy of Earth-like exoplanets. Don't worry, along with weird ultimate generation spectrographs and coronagraphs, Luvoir will be equipped with HDI, a really, really nice camera. HDI stands for High Definition Imager. This instrument is the primary instrument for imaging observations in the near ultraviolet through the near infrared. Think about what Hubble can do. Could you imagine what Luvoir will be able to do with this brand new camera? All the taken pictures will be probably printed and used in congresses, living rooms, and TV shows. It will be the beginning of a new era for science and the world. We've been saying that Luvoir could be the shocking successor of HST. Let's make some comparisons to understand why. HST was launched on April 24, 1990, and has inspired generations of scientists with such iconic images as the Pillars of Creation and the Hubble Extreme Deep Field. But sooner or later, we'll have to say goodbye. That's when Luvoir is supposed to kick in, and it will be capable of great things. If engineers will go for Luvoir A, for instance, they will be able to resolve structures as small as 100 PC anywhere in the visible universe. This critical scale corresponds to typical star formation scales, which is the reason why Luvoir will have a new window into the birth of stars and galaxies. These galaxies are so far that they are actually ultra-faint. Studying the ultra-faint requires a space telescope of Luvoir's scale, 15 meters in diameter, because the bigger the mirror is, the more light can be collected and the further we can observe. For example, the very first galaxies altered the universe as their host stars reionized the intergalactic medium. But we don't know how it really happens. To answer this, we must measure the contribution of galaxies to reionization, i.e. the total luminosity produced by those galaxies. Ultrafaint observations with Luvoir can reach depths where the luminosity function turnover could be clearly detected. Hey, if you're still here, it means you're really enjoying this video. Why don't you subscribe now and press the bell notification? But not only Luvoir will allow us to observe the first lights in the universe, it will also provide near flyby quality observations of solar system bodies. For instance, Luvoir will reveal currently unseen details of the solar system's dwarf planets. As you can see, the derived surface map of Pluto, based on high-resolution imaging with HST, is nothing compared to the simulated Luvoir images. These simulations resolve spatial scales of 55 miles for Luvoir A and 105 miles for Luvoir B for Pluto. This means we could see squares of 55 or 105 miles in great detail at the distance of Pluto. Given that Pluto is not even a planet, this can help you understand how powerful this telescope will be. Luvoir's unprecedented resolution and ability to track solar system objects will also enable remote studies of the moons, asteroids, and comets in our solar system, producing images with resolution comparable to NASA's Juno mission, the first explorer to peer below the planet's dense clouds to answer questions about the gas giant itself and the origins of our solar system. Talking about exoplanets instead, Luvoir will directly image, detect, and measure the orbits of hundreds of exoplanets of all types, from hot Jupiters to cold sub-Neptunes, super-Earths, revolutionizing our understanding of planet formation and evolution. And it will probably be the key instrument for the search for life as we know it. We already know exoplanets are strange worlds. Who knows, maybe this telescope will show us even weirder planets, or maybe it will find the first real twin of the Earth. But perhaps the most amazing thing will be this one. Not only will we have info about already formed exoplanets, we'll also have the chance to study them while they are forming. In fact, astronomers know that planets form out of a disk of dust and gas surrounding the star in the first stages of its evolution. Looking for these disks and studying them is one of the goals of the telescope. Luvoir achieves AU-scale imaging and spectroscopy of planet-forming disks, so we will be able to both see them and know what they're made of. High-resolution imaging over wide fields and multi-object UV spectroscopy will enable the measurement of the structure and composition of protoplanetary environments in unprecedented detail. For example, LUMOS will enable the first census of a planet-forming disk abundances, CO, H2O, CH4, O2, including molecular hydrogen, H2. This is really important to understand how planets formed and evolved, and maybe how the Earth itself did. Moreover, using LUMOS to study multiple star-forming regions, we survey when, where, and how much material is available to create the envelopes and atmospheres of both rocky and gas giant planets. The time for a mission like Luvoir is now. If there's one thing that we understood about exoplanets, is that small, rocky planets are common. Investments in starlight suppression technologies, such as coronagraphs, have lowered the risk of these mission concepts to an acceptable level. As Scott Gowdy from The Ohio State University stated in his paper, we can now start the development of a large strategic mission that will be a great successor to HST and will not only answer some of the most fundamental questions in astrophysics and planetary science, but may also finally answer the question of whether or not there is life elsewhere in the universe. Aren't you excited? That's all for this video. What do you think about the Luvoir Space Telescope concept? Let us know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to share it. And I'll see you next time on the channel.